In this unit, we'll learn about the Domain Name System, or DNS for short. The identification of an endpoint is done via the IP address. But servers have a verbal URL, such as yahoo.com. Network routers don't work with URLs, but with IPs. The URLs are meant for people, who obviously find it more comfortable to use meaningful verbal addresses than number-based IP addresses. The question is, how can we map, that is, match, a server's URL to its IP address? DNS provides these translation and mapping services. This service is accomplished by a database dispersed over multiple servers, arranged in a hierarchy we'll learn about later. A client who needs to search for a match between a URL and an IP address will refer to this system with a special request to have it respond with the required IP. As mentioned, DNS was invented to make people's use of communication networks easier. People easily remember names, but not numerical addresses such as IPs. The DNS bridges this gap by converting the verbal address that the user memorized into the IP address, which the computer uses to communicate with the destination. This service can be explained simply as a phone book, which translates the domain name to a numerical address. However, DNS servers are even more complex since the address inventory is distributed. This distribution is expressed in the fact that relatively small parts of the world address inventory are distributed across multiple computers called DNS servers hierarchically. This ensures that access and response times will be fast. The protocol allowing access to the distributed database and conversion of the URL to an IP is also called DNS. This protocol belongs to the application layer. DNS allows offering additional name services like email server registration. There are several reasons why DNS is not located at a central location. The first reason is a single point of failure. In the event of a power drop or an attack on the server, no users will receive services at all. The second reason is overloads. The number of global DNS requests is hundreds of millions every day, maybe even more. With a central location, the load will be impossible and will go over the infrastructure capacity so that no requests will be fulfilled. The third reason is the distance of clients on the other side of the globe. Long distances will cause large delays in services. In other words, will damage services. The fourth reason is maintenance. Maintaining a centralized system with worldwide throughput costs a fortune, infrastructure upgrades, and so on. There are other reasons having to do with the political sphere, matters of centralized control and power in the hands of an organization, and so on. A very important point is that the system has to be flexible to expand and change, because websites are established and change also in terms of their URLs. So, DNS is a hierarchical domain name registration system. Every server has listings, called resource records. These records allow it to handle requests for a particular area of names. These records divide the field they are responsible for into areas. The server knows to refer requests to servers responsible for these areas. The process of querying about a specific name is done by a request from a server and receiving a referral to a server, which will most likely be able to provide the answer or at least come closer to a server which can respond. The process ends when there is an exact answer from a server responsible for the domain of the requested name, or from a server which is not responsible but contains the answer in its cache. This process of checking is called an iterative process. It's mostly done by servers belonging to the ISP. Personal computers will usually not know how to perform it, but only to refer to the ISP server in order to perform it for them. Such a request is called a recursive request, and we'll talk about both of these methods shortly. The hierarchic network contains servers called root servers. These servers can refer the request to the relevant servers for any address it requests. The servers in the next level are responsible for upper-level domain names called top-level domains, or TLD for short. Those are all domain names using a specific last label of a name. For example, a query from a root-level server concerning .il will be referred to the server in charge of all the Israeli domain names. This server can refer to a second-level server, the .co server, that is, the server in charge of commercial Israeli websites. This server will deal with the third part, the name of the site, which will refer the request to the site's host server and check that the client is interested in the IP address of the www.internet server and provide the desired address. Another example, let's say a client wants to access the website www.amazon.com. The browser doesn't know the website address, that is, it doesn't save it in its cache due to a previous accessing. In such a case, the client refers to one of the root servers in order to find a DNS server dealing with .com, that is, one of the top-level servers of the domain of .com. The root server returns to the client the IP address of the TLD server, and the client refers to the .com TLD in order to get the IP address of the DNS server for Amazon.com. After getting this IP address, the client refers to the DNS server of Amazon.com, which is the authoritative server, in order to get the site address, which is www.amazon.com. The DNS protocol works on top of the network layer TCP and UDP protocols in port 53. When in most cases communication will amount to a single UDP packet containing the query, and another packet containing the response. Any answer provided by a server has a lifetime value attached, called TTL, or time to live. This value determines how long the request sender may save the response in its cache. This mechanism is intended to decrease the load on DNS servers and allows to prevent situations with multiple requests being made for the same domain name by a single server, when the response hasn't changed. When the response's time to live expires, the sender will have to ask the server about the desired domain name again. However, the server may not be queried if the client already has a listing in their computer's memory. The root servers receive referrals if a local server can't find the IP address for the client. The root servers query authoritative servers if they don't have a mapping for the TLD, and then return the mapping itself to the local server. There are 13 logical root servers worldwide. Each logical server is actually duplicated and constructed several times in order to reduce loads. In the second layer of the hierarchy, there are TLD servers responsible for domain names by country or field. The fields are subdivided by org, com, net, edu, and so on. Countries are divided by end names, JP for Japan, IL for Israel, UK for Britain, and so on. The third layer contains the authoritative servers, owned by the organizations or service providers, which contain IP addresses to additional internal DNS servers in hosts within the organization. There are additional servers that are not in the hierarchy trees, which are the local DNS servers existing on a local level. These servers are sometimes called default name servers. Every ISP has at least one such server. The amount is usually determined by the number of clients it has. When a client sends a query to search for an IP, it first of all sends it to the local server. The local server may have the address in local cache due to previous requests from the same client or other clients referring to that server. So the server will provide the address directly to the client and save a search in the hierarchical tree. If the local server has no translation to the address the client requested, the local server serves as a proxy and searches through the hierarchical tree, as we explained in the previous slides. When the server receives the address, it will save it in its cache for the next times, and will reset the time to live variable and send it to the client. In this unit, we learned what DNS servers are, about the hierarchical tree of these servers, and which DNS servers exist.